Welcome to Storycraft Studio. Today, we'll be turning this Frankenstein doll into Disguse from the Pixar movie Inside Out. I love Inside Out, and Disguse was one of my favorite characters because she was just so sassy and stylish. I love sassy characters, and her 50s style is one of my favorites. I've been wanting to do this doll for a while, but the summer humidity made it really difficult. She had to stay on my shelf for a really long time, but I was finally able to finish her, and now here she is free to see. Let's start her face up. All face-ups start with gathering the supplies, and then you move on to the sketch. Unfortunately, due to time constraints, I couldn't video all the layers. But here are some progress shots, and this last one shows that I've covered in the eyes with white. This is because I had the crazy idea of doing these contacts, inspired by the frog blog. It's crazy. It's kind of jarring how well it works, but here you see, it works, and I may do this next time I have to do really tight deadlines, but we shall see. It's a little uncanny. Here we see me adding the eyelashes. They were a little tricky. I knew I needed to do something really crazy because it's Disguse and her eyelashes are a huge part of her character. So while I was visiting my sister earlier this summer, I got hold of tinsel eyelashes. And they were a little tricky to work with and get the right size, but they work really well. I really look forward to trying to do eyelashes for my future dolls, but here's my first try, and I don't think it's too bad. Disguse wig starts with this yarn with metallic threads through it to give that shiny quality for her character. Then I cut them into strands before brushing them out with my putty brush, and then they end up like this. With the straight iron, they become soft and glossy even with the holographic bits. Then I use the Hextian method of hot gluing to make my wefts. I use the Scotch tape method to make the wig cap, and then layer on the wefts using more hot glue, and sometimes just using the tip to melt the hot glue holding the weft together to make it really flat. I wanted to give it a really nice shape. Then it comes out so long and fluffy and just, it's too much hair. So in a second, I just cut it off to the right length and start trying to style it. Then in the next panel, we'll see how that came out. Wait, why did I say panel? I meant clip. Here we see the final styling, and it's so cute, and I'm really happy with it. But this isn't how it comes out at the end, because I had to take it off, of course, and then I had to sit, and I tried to use holographic glitter paint to keep the style, but it doesn't work as well as this. But it still comes out really cute. I use this pattern made by myself to make the dress. I cut them out of this floral and damask pattern. Then I stitch the two circles stitched together along the edges, flip it out, and then overstitch to get a nice turned edge. To make the bodice, I first sew the top pieces of the front to the bottom, then the back to the front on the shoulders. Then you just turn it out and then sew the side, and it comes out very nicely. I use pins to hand ruffle the skirt waist before sewing it onto the dress. I would usually put in snaps or Velcro, but I decided to try and stitch her in to get that nice tight fit. The pants, I use this pattern and a stretch cotton to do it. Come out in these two pieces, which I was going to color with those fabric markers, then I decided against it. Then I sew the crotch and hem the pants bottoms before sewing the other side of the crotch. Then just up along the whole legs, and it comes out really well. Then I dipped it in some dye and just let it sit to get the color. For the shoes, I took her shoes, the original Frankenstein's shoes, and covered the heel in my moldable plastic to get a smooth heel. I could have cut it, but I had more confidence in the moldable plastic. Then just work on both of them to get them even, paint, and then put a little jewel on the button. Comes out really, really cute. For the accessories, I did a bracelet using more moldable plastic, and then for her D-buckle, more moldable plastic painted green. Some pink glitter tulle is the last touch, and then we're ready to put her together. Sweet Frankie before and after. Mahalo for watching, guys. Be sure to check out my previous videos and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out on future ones. Between videos, I post a lot of stuff on Instagram, so be sure to follow me, and Tumblr, where I occasionally post. I should probably post more there. But all the links are below, as well as some resources and links to videos or accounts that I mentioned earlier. Thanks so much and see you around. Aloha!